Welcome to Great Hymns of the Faith. My name is John Fraser. I'm your host, and I have a number of hymns that I'm going to enjoy sharing with you today. Our first hymn is a great hymn of praise, and it has an interesting story behind it. Let me share a little bit of that story with you. London's founding hospital was an orphanage that became famous for singing this hymn. The hospital was founded in 1739 by a merchant named Thomas Coram, who was also involved in promoting the Wesleys' evangelistic efforts in Georgia. By the early 1800s, it was quite in vogue for Londoners to visit Sunday services at the orphanage, where the children were led in singing by trained musicians and could be observed at dinner in their quaint costumes. Handel was so fond of the institution that he donated a chapel organ and gave a number of benefit performances of Messiah to raise funds for it. The founding hospital is remembered today chiefly through a hymn book called Psalms, Hymns, and Anthems of the Founding Hospital, London, which was published by Coram in 1796. Now, here's where it gets interesting, folks. Paste it into the jacket of that hymn book were the words to this hymn. Though there is much conjecture about the authorship of the text, each theory has been refuted, and the hymn remains anonymous. What's the name of the hymn? Well, it's our first hymn for today, and it is called Praise the Lord, Ye Heavens Adore Him. Let's move on now to a hymn that is indeed a favorite of many. The year was 1885. He was a Swedish preacher, young age, 26. His name was Carl G. Boberg. He wrote the words to a poem entitled, O Stor Gud. Now, several years later, he attended a meeting and was surprised to hear his poem being sung to an old Swedish melody. In the early 1920s, English missionary Stuart K. Hine and his wife were ministering in Poland. There they learned the Russian version of Boberg's poem, coupled with the original Swedish melody. Later, Hine wrote original English words and made his own arrangement of the Swedish melody, which became popular and is now known as the hymn. Do you know what it is? Well, if you said How Great Thou Art, you are absolutely correct. Enjoy. Mm-hmm.
awesome wonder. Consider all the worlds thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder. Thy power throughout the universe displayed.
Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee.
How great thou art! With shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art.
Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee.
How great thou art!
How great thou art!
How great thou art!
How great thou art!
Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee.
This past summer, Jill and I were privileged to have been on a road trip, and we were able to visit our three daughters, all 11 of our grandchildren as well. Then we went on to visit Jill's sister and Jill's brother, and we even made a trip to Nova Scotia. And what a joy it was to visit the town of Oxford, where I spent, about 10 years of my life there and growing up in the neighborhood. And I had a really great friend who lived just across the street from me, and his name was Billy. And I even got to speak to him and got a picture of him. Jill took a picture of us, and I treasure that greatly. Friends are so important. We all need friends. You know the hymn, "What a Friend We Have in Jesus." Jesus certainly wants to be a close friend to all of his children. Folks, I'm going to share with you now a piece. I've played it before. I enjoy it. It's sung by Foster and Allen, and this particular piece is called "My Forever Friend."
Everybody needs a little help sometime. No one stands alone. Makes no difference if you're just a child like me or a king upon a throne. For there are no exceptions. We all stand in the line. Everybody needs a friend. Let me tell you of mine. He's my forever friend. I leave me never, friend. darkest night to rainbow's end. He's my forever friend. Even when I turn away, he cares for me. His love no one can shake. Even as I walk away, he's by my side with every breath I take. And sometimes I forget him, my halo fails to shine. Sometimes I'm not his friend, but he is always mine. He's my forever friend. My leave me never friend. From darkest night to rainbow's end, he's my forever friend. If you still don't know the one I'm talking of, I think it's time you knew. Long ago and far away, upon a cross, my friend died for you. So if you'd like to meet him and don't know what to do, ask my friend into your heart, and he'll be your friend too. He's my forever friend, my leave me never friend. From darkest night to rainbow's end, he's my forever friend. Jesus is my best friend.
Let's move on now to yet another hymn, and I know this hymn also will be familiar to you. The author's name is Horatio G. Spafford. In the mid-1870s, he lost his four daughters when two ships collided at sea. His wife was spared, but his daughters, all four of them, were lost. Spafford was a Christian, and the story goes that Dwight L. Moody left meetings in Edinburgh and went to Liverpool to try to comfort Spafford and his wife. He was greatly pleased, so I'm informed, to find that they were able to say, "It is well, the will of God be done." Horatio Spafford, in the year 1876, penned the words to the hymn called "It Is Well With My Soul."
Like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to say, it is well.
Well with my soul, it is
of this glorious thought. My sin not in part, but the whole is nailed to his cross, and I bear it no more. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, O my soul. It is well with my soul. It is well, it is well with my soul.
While living in Calgary, Alberta, Canada, Jill and I were blessed with the opportunity of taking a group of people from our church and surrounding areas on a tour of the Holy Land. It was relatively safe to go back then, although one still had to be very cautious. While visiting in the Holy Land, and in particularly in Jerusalem, our guide said to us, "You know, where Jesus walked when he was on this earth many years ago is probably about 20 feet below the ground level that you're walking on right now." And then he went on to say, "But there is one exception. You remember in the story after his arrest, he was taken up to the house of Caiaphas, the high priest. And Caiaphas' house was located on a bit of a hill, and going up that hill, there are these huge stone steps. If you walked on those steps, you probably were walking on the very steps that Jesus walked on so many years before." Folks, if Jesus is indeed your Lord and your Savior, if you are called to be one of his children, then you know that Jesus will walk with you wherever you happen to be, wherever you lived. You can say, "He walks with me." Now I'm going to share a hymn with you sung by Pat Boone, and it is called "I Walk Today Where Jesus Walked."
I walked today where Jesus walked, in days of long ago. I wandered down each path he knew, with reverent step and slow. Those little lanes, they have not changed. A sweet peace fills the air. I walked today where Jesus walked, and felt his presence there. My pathway led through Bethlehem, our memories ever sweet. The little hill of Galilee that knew those childish feet. The Mount of Olives hallowed scenes that Jesus knew before. I saw the mighty Jordan roll as in the day
today where Jesus knelt, where all alone he prayed, the Garden of Gethsemane. My heart felt unafraid. I picked my heavy burden up, and with him by my side, I climbed the hill of Calvary. I climbed the hill of Calvary. I climbed the hill of Calvary, where on the cross he died. I walked today where Jesus walked, and felt him
as many of you are probably aware, I'm originally from Nova Scotia, Canada. Jill, my wife, was originally from Ontario, Canada. However, we're living now in Florida. I know that we have many listeners who live in Canada, who live in the U.S., who are there in the U.K., who are in Fife area of Scotland. We have listeners in Australia, and we have listeners in New Zealand. And as of late, we have listeners also in India. And if I haven't mentioned your place, your country, your home, please drop me a note and let me know. God has blessed us with a home here on earth. He does indeed continue to bless us each and every day that we spend here. When times get tough, he gives us the grace to pull through, to continue our journey. But we know that someday our journey is going to take us, by God's grace, God's mercy, to our eternal home. I want to share with you now a piece by Canadian folk singer Tommy Hunter called "This World Is Not My Home."
This world is not my home, I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. I have a loving mother just over in Glory Land, and I don't expect to stop until I shake her hand. She's waiting now for me in heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Just over in Glory Land, we'll live eternally. The saints on every hand are shouting victory. Their songs of sweetest praise drift back from heaven's shore, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore.
Folks, here's a children's hymn that I know you're going to love. When was the last time you heard the hymn Jesus Loves Me sung in your church? If it's been quite a while, hey, why not ask them? Because that little children's hymn teaches us so much about the love of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Please join us next week for more great hymns of the faith. Until then, God bless.